Hey, it's Tina Forsyth here. So, how do you actually measure success in your business? What are the real measures of success? It's easy to think that it's just about revenue. It's easy to think that it's just about sales. Because, of course, that's what we hear all the time. That's what everybody talks about. I made this amount of money. I had a five-figure month, a six-figure launch, a seven-figure whatever, etc. But here's the thing. It goes true success for you as an entrepreneur, true success for you as a purposeful CEO, as the leader of your company, you want to take a stand on true success beyond just that number, beyond just the revenue. So I want to share with you the three key areas that you need to measure success in your company, for you as the entrepreneur, for you as the CEO and the leader of your company. Number one is money. Now, it's not just the revenue. You want to know your revenue. You want to know your sales. Absolutely. Those are really important numbers. But more important is profit. How much money is left over at the end of the day? You got money coming in, you got money going out. Whatever's left over is ultimately profit. And profit is way more important than revenue. I don't care how much money you're making. If it all goes right back out the door again, you're not successful here at all. And some of you may have felt that. I've had moments in my business where that's become very real for me. Cash flow. How are you managing when money's coming in and when money's going out so that you don't get into crunch mode, so that you don't get into trouble along the way? Because again, it can be easy enough to make money, but when does money actually come in? Who's paying what and when? And how do you balance all of that? You want to be able to manage cash flow, manage the health of the money coming in and out of your business. You also want to know what you're paying yourself and really be purposeful and real. Are you getting paid from your company? Are you happy with the amount of money that you're getting paid from your company? I know way too many people, it's almost a dirty little secret in some cases, where you're not paying yourselves. You're the leader of your company. You're the CEO of your company, and you're not getting paid, or you're getting paid last, or you're not getting paid enough. And I take a real stand on that. That's not what you're in it for here. Now, it's not about going, off the deep end and paying yourself to the exclusion of everything else, but you need to be getting paid here, and you want to make sure that you're getting paid in a way that actually creates success for you and the company in the work that you're doing. Now, number two, the second area that you want to measure success in is meaning. You are a purpose-led entrepreneur. You are doing the work that you're doing for a reason. I am too. It's not just about the almighty buck for me. Meaning is a big deal. I wouldn't be talking to you right here, right now, if I wasn't building my business on meaning, on purpose, for a reason. Of the difference that I want to make in the world. And so, how do you measure meaning? You want to take a look around at things from a couple of levels. So, for you personally, are you happy with the vision of the company? Have you set a really clear vision for the company? Do you know where you're headed? Do you know why you're going there? Have you shared that vision with the rest of the team, with the rest of the people working with you? Are they engaged in that vision? Are they excited about it? Are they happy and purposeful? Now, visions expire. A vision that you set a while ago, especially if you've already achieved it, it may not be valid anymore. Might be time for that next vision. Might be time for something different as well, too. So just know that vision is something you want to revisit on a very regular basis and to be able to bring to the company at large. How clear is a vision and how engaged is everyone on the team in the vision? Is everybody getting to operate in their strengths, including you? Are you getting to bring the best of who you are to the table each day? Is your role, are the expectations for you and everyone on the team allowing you to play in that space where you get to be the best of who you are? Or do you have too much shoulda, coulda, woulda, gotta do this, can't stand this, I'm not good at this, but it's on my plate anyhow? That is not fulfilling, ultimately, for anyone on the team. Ultimately, doesn't serve the business either. So you want to really be looking at and ensuring that everyone on the team gets to bring their best to the table, gets to bring their own personal strengths, and gets to be personally fulfilled in the work that they're doing. Now, it doesn't mean every day is sunshine and roses. It's not about being happy at work every day. I want to be very clear here. It's about, there's days when it sucks, there's days when it's hard. But when we know that ultimately the work that we're doing and the effort that we're putting in is the best of who we are and it's towards what matters, that's really important. How do you measure meaning? I kind of like to use the idea of a scale of 1 to 10, because we don't necessarily have like a meaning meter sitting around here that we can turn to and look at. But on a scale of 1 to 10, where do you feel like you're at in those areas when we're looking at meaning? Now, last but not least, number three is freedom. Freedom is the idea of being able to do what you want to do when you want to do it. Now, many people that I know, many entrepreneurs that I know, myself included, this is a big part of why we started our businesses in the first place. We didn't want to be put in a box. We didn't want to have somebody telling us what we needed to do, even if we didn't want to do it, and so on. So freedom is a biggie. Now, the two pieces of that again, are you able to do what you want to do? when you want to do it? Is your business set up so that it allows you to do the work that you want to do? So that it allows you to do what you want to do when you want to do it? Can you take time off from your business? Can you shut down at a decent hour every day and not be working till midnight every night? Can you take weekends off if you want to, if that's something important to you? Can you take a vacation? What happens if you're gone for a day or a week or a month? Is your business going to come to a screeching halt around you? If the business is not set up to run without you, in particular you as the CEO, as the leader of your company, then you're not successful in the freedom area yet. Now, believe me, you can get there. There's ways to structure your business model, your team, your systems, etc., that can really lend themselves to having a healthy business here. And if you're feeling trapped, if you're feeling like you're in that place where you are the hub of like, oh my gosh, it is all of me. And if I take a day off, I know it's going to be a disaster. I'm going to come back to a mess, let alone taking a week off. My goodness, I can't imagine. Just know that it's fixable. Know that it's fixable. And I really want you to honor for yourself the freedom that you actually want from your business. You don't get it overnight. Freedom is actually something that's earned more than given in business. And sometimes we've got to put in a little bit of blood, sweat, and tears to get there. But at the same token, too, when you know that freedom is important to you, and when you're very clear on what freedom means to you, then it's important to make sure that your business is successful there and that you're able to measure that. So again, the top three things, the top three areas that you want to be measuring: money, absolutely, profit, cash flow, where are you getting paid, all of that, so very important. Number two is meaning. How fulfilled are you and everyone on the team from the work that you're doing? Are you doing work that matters? Do you feel on purpose? Do you feel as though you're really, really making a difference in the way that you want to make a difference in the world? And freedom. Are you able to do what you want to do when you want to do it? Measures of success. Love it, love it. If you have any questions or comments or want to share where you feel like you're at in either of those three areas, go ahead and do so here with the video. I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to answer any questions that you have. And until next time, it's Tina Forsyth here. Take care. Bye now.